When it comes to nutrition, it's tempting to think that what's good for each of us is good for all of us. But Lee Cowan explains how new research into what we eat is getting personal.
It's been said the best meals come from the heart, not from a recipe book. But not here. In this USDA kitchen, there's no pinch of this, dash of that, no dollops or smidgens of anything. Here, nutritionists in white coats painstakingly measure every single ingredient, down to the tenth of a gram.
So what's for lunch?
Pizza.
Sharon Stover is expected to eat every crumb of that pizza. The staff even gave her a special tool to do just that.
Then you have to scrape it all out, and you lick it.
So you literally do everything except lick the plate.
Yes, absolutely, absolutely.
And the tiny morsels she does miss?
Thank you, lady.
Well, they go back to the kitchen, where they're scrutinized like evidence in some dietary crime.
At 78, not many people get to do studies that are going to affect a great amount of people. And I thought this was a great opportunity to do that.
Sharon, or participant number 3180, as she's known, is one of some 10,000 volunteers enrolled in a $170 million nutrition study run by the National Institutes of Health.
When I tell people about the study, the reaction usually is, oh, that's so cool, can I do it?
It's called the Nutrition for Precision Health Study. Coordinator Holly Nicastro explains just what precise precisely means.
Precision nutrition means tailoring nutrition or dietary guidance to the individual. There is no one best way to eat.
The government has long offered guidelines to help us eat better. In the 40s, we had the basic seven. In the 50s, the basic four. We've had the food wheel, the food pyramid, and currently, my plate.
Know what you eat. Know what it does for you. Food's out of sight.
Now, they're all well-intentioned, except that they're all based on averages. What works best for most people most of the time.
We know from virtually every nutrition study ever conducted, we have inter-individual variability. That means we have some people that are going to respond and some people that aren't. There's no one size fits all.
The study's participants, like Sharon, are all being drawn from another NIH program called All of Us, a massive undertaking to create a database of at least a million people who are volunteering everything from their electronic health records to their DNA. It was from that All of Us research, for example, that Sharon discovered that she has a gene that makes some foods taste bitter, which could explain why she ate more of one kind of food than another.
And the target is based on this number.
Professor Sai Das, overseeing the study here at Tufts University, says the goal of precision nutrition is to drill down even deeper into those individual differences.
We're moving away from just saying, you know, everybody go do this, to being able to say, okay, if you have X, Y, and Z characteristics, then you're more likely to respond to a diet. And someone else that has ABC characteristics will be responding to the diet differently.
That's a big commitment for you, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. It means a lot to me.
Sharon is just one of 150 people who are being paid to live at a handful of test sites all around the country for 6 weeks, 2 weeks at a time. It's so precise, she can't even go for a walk without a dietary chaperone.
Well, you could stop and buy candy, or you could stop and have food, or God forbid, you know, you can't do that.
Okay, are you ready?
Yep, I'm ready.
While she's here, everything from her resting metabolic rate,
measuring your weight,
her body fat percentage,
alrighty, so your head will come back towards me,
her bone mineral content, even the microbes in her gut are being analyzed, digested by this machine. It's essentially a smart toilet paper reading device.
We really think that what's going on in your poop is going to tell us a lot of information about your health and how you respond to food.
Sharon says she really doesn't mind, except for the odd sound it makes.
If you're doing it in the middle of the night, it's going boom, 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 and boom, 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 boom.
While Sharon is a live-in participant, thousands of others are participating from their homes, where electronic wearables track all kinds of health data, including these special glasses that record everything they eat. But they're only activated when someone like me starts chewing.
I won't hear anything or see or know.
You will not hear anything, but it knows that now that you've put food in your mouth, that is what it needs to be capturing.
Artificial intelligence can then be used to determine not only which foods I'm eating, but how many calories I actually consumed.
It knows these are cornflakes. It knows what kind of milk, how much milk.
The study is expected to be wrapped up by 2027. And because of it, we may indeed know not only to just eat more fruits and vegetables, but what combination of foods is really best for us. The question, though, that even Holly Nicastro can't answer is, will we listen?
Will it in the end help people eat better?
You can lead a horse to water, you can't make them drink. We can tailor the interventions all day. But one hypothesis I have is that if the guidance is tailored to the individual, it's going to make that individual more likely to follow it. Because this is for me. This was designed for me.